I hope you all will be enjoying your online classes. So let's start our today's session. In our today's session, finally, we are going to start the study of modern periodic table. So as I have taught you in the previous sessions, there were lot of drawbacks in the Mendeley periodic tables and earlier attempts which were given in terms of classification of elements. Okay, so here the point which I am going to tell you. First of all, here we have to understand, actually Mendeley, that he thought he should arrange, or he chose the pattern he should arrange all the elements in increasing order of their atomic masses. Okay, but as I have taught you in the previous session, he put some mistakes when he was placing some heavier elements. So what he did, heavier element he put before the lighter elements. Those were having the lighter atomic masses, they were kept before, kept after the heavier one elements. Okay, so this was the wrong order. Okay, so finally, to remove all the anomalies of Mendeley periodic table, so modern scientists, they discuss a lot, and finally the Henry Moseley was a scientist. He gave a new concept about the modern periodic table. हेनरी मोज़ले ने बोला कि अगर मेंडलीव की पीरियोडिक टेबल का जो पीरियोडिक लॉ था कि उसने जितने भी एलिमेंट्स थे उनको अरेंज किया इन इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर ऑफ देयर एटॉमिक मासेस, अगर हमें वहां पे मिस्टेक्स मिल रही है तो व्हाई वी शुड नॉट चेंज द मेन लॉ. सो ही चेंज्ड द लॉ दैट ही सेड दैट द एलिमेंट्स शुड अरेंज इन देयर इंक्रीजिंग एटॉमिक नंबर. देन ही सेड दैट the properties of elements are periodic functions of their atomic number, not on the atomic masses. So when this pattern was followed, then there were lot of anomalies and there were lot of drawbacks in Mendeley periodic table that were removed now. Okay, so now Henry Moseley was the scientist who gave the modern periodic law, and this concept we are following in the modern concept in the modern periodic table. Okay, and that says that the properties of elements are periodic function of their atomic numbers, not on their atomic masses. So what he did, what Mendeley did in his periodic table, now slowly I will teach all the pattern. Okay, so now he arranged all the elements means simply you can say all the known elements at that time, because when he gave his law, then still few elements were not discovered. We are having a big periodic table now. So he arranged all the elements in groups and periods. So here PD represents the period and GP for the group. So he said that all horizontal rows were called periods, and all vertical columns were called groups. He said that, like here I am telling, these are the horizontal rows, these are to be considered like that. This is to be 1, 2 and 3. So these are to be horizontal rows, so these are to be considered as period. And suppose we are talking about the growth, so what is to be done in this way? These are the growths, the vertical columns, okay? So these vertical columns are to be known as groups, and these are to be of known as period. But here you have to understand, groups are to be vertical, so their numbers are to be done, numbering is to be done in horizontal ways. But periods are the horizontal lines, so their numbering is to be done in the vertical. Okay, so here you have to write, groups are numbered in horizontal way, or horizontally simply you can write. But periods are to be numbered in vertical, okay, or vertical way, simply you can write whatever the language suits to you. Okay, so the detailed explanation of groups we will study later on, but in today's session I have brought the study of periods in detail. Okay, so actually when he was arranging all the elements, so he made, what he did, he made 18 groups and 7 periods. So here the topic I'm picking periods here. So see here, periods, period, as I have taught, horizontal rows were called periods. And actually I have written there, he made the 7 periods. So here we have to write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. 7 periods were there. Okay, so that we can write there, these were the periods, they were the 7 periods. And number of elements in each period, that number of elements present in each period were, the first period that is having only the 2 elements, if you will see in the modern periodic table, then in the second period 8 elements are to be present, in third period again 8, fourth period 18, fifth period 18, sixth period 32, and last one. Actually, recently the periodic table has been completed. There are 118 elements new. Some more elements have been discovered, but at that time this period was incomplete, so 29 elements were there. So that as you have seen, new elements those have discovered. Now some few spaces were left. If you will see in the notebook, we will discuss the periodic table in detail also. Okay. So what newly element discovered and where they have got the proper spaces. Now here I am just going to tell you what names was given to that specific period. So the first period, because it is having only 2 elements, so he gave the name of that period. This is a very short period because it is having only 2 elements. Okay. Now the second and third period, if you will see, they both are having the same numbers of elements. So he gave the name short period. Okay, this is a very short period and these two are of the short period, you can say. Okay, these two are of short period because they both are having 4th and 5th, they both are having 18 elements. So this is of long period. This period was considered long period. Okay, now this is having the maximum number of elements in the periodic table, so that was given, the name was given very long period. Okay, and the last one, here I am telling once again, ab periodic table mein pure 180 elements ho gaye hain, but still this period was not completed, but when this concept was given, so this period was having 29 elements. So we just say that this is incomplete period. So in the theoretical concept, whenever we study, the 6th period were completed, but the 7th period was incomplete, that we have to understand. So this was the detailed study about the period that was given by the Henry Moseley. Okay, and in the next session we will study about the detailed study of group wise all the groups in detail properly. Okay, so that's all for today's session. Till then, goodbye and have a nice day.